Life and origin of sled dogs. The first people to populate the Arctic had dogs with them that had already been bred for thousands of years to both pull sleds and hunt. Without these dogs, humans could not have ventured so far into the Arctic wilderness and lived. But what made these dogs so special? While there are many polar dog breeds, they all share a so-called double coat, a thick underwool that allows them to withstand Arctic temperatures. The bushy tail provides protection for the sensitive snout. Inuit sled dogs can withstand minus 25 degrees Celsius without discomfort. The fur equally helps the dogs to stay cool in summer. Yet this powerful insulation layer also makes it very difficult to get rid of heat. This limits how fast they can run. Today, these old polar breeds are rarely used for racing. The padded paws and strong claws move easily on snow and ice. They also act as sensors to warn of unsafe sea or river ice. Many a sled driver's life has been saved by trusting their dog's instincts. The ears are heavily furred to keep the snow and wind out. Like most Arctic species, bears, foxes, seals, and humans, polar dogs thrive on fat and meat in their diet. Inuit sled dogs are traditionally fed every second day in winter and only once a week in summer. Siberian huskies were not fed at all in summer and were turned loose to fend for themselves. Greenland sled dogs not only pull sleds, but are also used to hunt and even fight polar bears. To this day, the hunting instinct is very strong in these ancient breeds. There are many different breeds of polar dogs. Let's look at some that have contributed most to today's sled dogs. Malamute huskies are the basic breed for most modern sled dogs. They are an ancient breed used for hunting and transport by the native Malamute people of Alaska. These big dogs are stubborn, loyal, strong, thick-furred, and outside the Arctic, usually too hot. This makes them relatively slow, but perfect for polar expeditions with heavy loads. Malamutes have a strong hunting instinct and may look upon smaller dogs as snacks. The Greenland sled dog is an impressively strong breed used for hunting and transport by the natives of Greenland. Their tough lives and fights with polar bears make them fierce survivors, and it is a bad idea to try cuddling them. Alas, these majestic dogs are endangered. To protect them, it is not allowed to bring any other dogs to Greenland. The Siberian husky was bred by the Chukchi people of Siberia. The dogs were used to pull sleds, but also to keep babies warm. Aggressive dogs were not tolerated. Siberian huskies are loving towards people, but have a strong hunting instinct. Only a handful of Siberian huskies was imported to Alaska. They were recognized by the legendary sled dog breeder Leonard Seppala for their cooperative spirit, endurance, and their ability to make the most very little food. In Siberia, these dogs have sadly become extinct. Today, the Siberian Husky is an American breed. The Alaska Gold Rush brought thousands of people to the high north, and the demand for sled dogs was enormous. Any dogs big enough to pull a sled were crossed with the local Inuit dogs. The Alaska Husky was born, not a breed, but rather a motley group of mutts in all shapes, colors, and sizes.
All the dogs we have here in the dog yard are Alaskan Huskies. The Alaskan Husky is not a pure breed, it's not a specific breed, it's more a type of a dog. So the type of dog Alaskan Husky is as a polar fur, like it can survive in polar and sub-zero temperatures well. and they have the instinct to pull and run, and once you have those two things, you are basically an Alaskan Husky.
They are a very social breed, first of all. Like they like to live in packs as well, and like to live outdoors.
The Siberian Huskies, they still have the pulling instinct. They still have a good Arctic fur, a polar fur to survive. But they will be normally be a lot slower than the Alaskan Huskies are at running. So if you were like for doing long distance dog training, running for long distance dog training races, it will always be the Alaskan Huskies who comes out on the top, because they are able to maintain a higher pace at running while pulling the same amount of weight. On the other hand, if you were to go on an expedition, you would maybe choose a different breed, like the Malamutes or Greenland Huskies, because you will have these very cold temperatures. They don't move so fast, so the faster the dogs move, the more energy they will use, and also the faster you move, the higher the risk of injuries are as well. So when you're out on a long distance expedition, where it's very cold, you have extremely heavy sledge, you will want a breed that has a thick fur that pulls heavy but not runs too fast. And this is both for their paws to not get sore, but also wrists and shoulders.
Originally, Alaska Huskies were big and had a lot of fur. They were bred to pull heavy loads. Once motorized vehicles took over polar transport, Alaska Huskies were used for racing and leisure. They became lighter, had less thick fur, and thus got faster. In the last 100 years, snow scooters, helicopters, and airplanes have replaced sled dogs. The Inuit still use their dogs, but their lifestyle and dogs are endangered. The rest of us use polar dogs to race, go for pleasure sled rides, ski, cycle, hike, or simply enjoy each other's company, as has been our way since thousands of years with our oldest, best friends.
The material was prepared for the project EDU ARCTIC 2, from polar research to scientific passion, innovative nature education in Poland and Norway, which receives a grant of €240,000 received from Iceland, Liechtenstein and Norway under EEA funds.